皆さんこんにちは。日本の、東北大学から来ました石井山と申します。
Hello, my name is Ryuhei Ishiyama from Tohoku University, Japan. Nice to meet you today.
まず皆さんにお詫びをしなければなりません。私の報告が日本語でありますこと、それから同時通訳でないことをご容赦ください。
First of all, I would like to apologize that today's I'm going to speak in Japanese and it's not going to be interpreted at the same time. We have to use this method. So please understand our situation.
実は私自身逐次通訳になることを知ったのは昨日のことでした。昨日1日報告内容を見直し半分に削りました。ですので本来用意してみたものを大幅に削減した内容であることもご容赦いただきたいと思います。
And also, I just found out yesterday that the interpretation will be done this way, which means that my talk will be cut in half instead of 25 minutes. So there might be some parts that it's hard to understand. So I apologize beforehand.
与えられたテーマは第四次産業革命ということです。まず皆さんに一番最初に申し上げないといけないのは、日本ではこの第四次産業革命ということは韓国ほど関心が向いていません。
First of all, the topic of today is about the fourth industrial revolution. However, in Japan, people don't really talk about this topic as much as they do in Korea.
とはいえ、それがテーマですので、近年、文部省のレベルではどういう検討がされているかということについて資料を用意してきました。しかし、時間の関係でこの内容は省きます。
However, we do have in Japan, we did talk about the about this topic, and there was a conference on.As you see on the board, the summary on the building a social education system that could contribute towards social development and enhancing people's everyday lives. This was a conference that was held in March 28th this year. And because of the time restraint, I'm going to skip this, the contents of the topic.
私はここに取り上げられていない問題を今から取り上げたいと思います。東日本大震災を経験した観点から、テクノロジーにとって変わられない。人間こそが果たすべき役割とそのための地域学習のあり方について論じたいと思います。
However, I would like to focus more on the topic that is not presented on the previous topic, on the conference that was held in Japan, which is about the community learning that cultivates roles, which only humans could play and that cannot be replaced by technology.From the viewpoint of somebody who has experienced the Great East Japan earthquake that happened in 2011.
端的に言えばその役割とは地域生活のリスクに未然に気づきそこを連帯しながら乗り越えていくことです。そうした学習力、研究力、運動力をいかに地域が蓄えていくかがこれから問われているように思います。
And such is that how the community is going to increases capabilities to learn, study and participate and how to build such capabilities in the communities and its people.
本報告ではそのことをライフラインということと関連付けながら論じます。
And in my report, I'm going to connect this to the term called lifeline and please think about this term as well.
2011年の3月以降、電気や水が止まり流通が途絶えた震災直後の日々を経験したことで芽生えた私の主要な関心事がこのライフラインということです。
And the topic is of my interest because I have experienced a situation where the water line, water, gas, and electricity, as well as the products, has been cut due to the great earthquake.
蛇口の向こうが果たして安全なのか、コンセントの向こうで電気はどう作られているのか。自分たちの命を支える食料がどのように生産されているのか、このことへの関心と想像力を人間が持ち続けることこそ、社会が持続可能であり続けるためには不可欠なのではないでしょうか。
And through this experience, I came up with three questions, such as, is our water supply really safe beyond the, and do we really know what lies beyond the water pipes that we see? And how is the electricity generated behind the sockets we usually just use? And,Also about our food, how do we grow the food that supports our lives? And these are, thinking about these questions, aren't they going to enhance our imagination? or towards enhancing social sustainability.
そして、震災後の東北エリアではこのライフラインをめぐる政財界と住民生活のせめぎ合い、その矛盾を乗り越えようとする民主との学習運動の新たな展開が随所に現れています。そのうち3つを今回皆さんにはご紹介いたします。
And in Japan, in Tohoku area of Japan, where it was affected by the earthquake, there has been a lot of movements by the community to overcome such the issues that arise due to the earthquake. However, there are many examples. I'm going to talk about three the most important examples today.
一つ目のトピックは水をめぐってです。震災後福島を越えて宮城県にやってきた放射性物質の最終処分場を宮城県の上町という町に作る計画に対して起きた反対運動、学習運動を紹介します。
First of all, I'm going to talk about the topic of water and I'm going to talk about the case of 上町 in 宮崎 prefecture
宮城
prefecture where there was a talk about building a final repository for the nuclear reactors.
しかし時間の関係で、説明は大幅に削減しないといけません。ポイントだけお話をします。
Due to the time restraint, I will only talk about the most important points.
国や県が主導した処分場計画に対しておかしいと直感した、当該地域の町長、この写真の真ん中におられる方なんですが、独自の調査を開始をしました。
Against the, as you see on the picture, the man with the mic is the village chief of the village that was supposed to be the site for the repository, and he conducted the independent research about the site because they thought the research taken by the national government was not trustable.
その計画の細部を研究者の力も借りながら検討し直し、結果その過ちを暴き出し、それを大部分の住民が支持し大きな運動となり、2年の後計画が一旦白紙となったという事例です。
Their research actually found out that there has been some administrative mistakes made by the government when they first conducted the research on the site, and after 2 years,The town actually succeeded in stopping the government from selecting their town as the site for the repository.
日本では中央政府の方針に地方政府、特に小規模の自治体は従順であるのが多勢である中、沖縄の基地問題などの国と地方の対立はあくまで例外として捉えられていましたが、同様な事態が震災後の東北に生まれているということです。
And in Japan, you hear a lot about the Okinawa base issues. However, the local government and central government, they usually agree, they usually fight between such issues. But these small towns, they don't have power to fight over the central government's decision.
しかもそこで取り組まれた研究や学習や運動の先に国や県の方針の過ちを明らかにし、それを撤回させるにまで至ったことは私にとっては大きな驚きでした。
And about the Kami town experience, in this situation, it's very hard for the small town to actually go against what the central government wanted the plans and find the mistakes and succeeding in stopping the original plan.To me, this was a very emotional experience.
この、処分場の建設予定地が水道水源地を大きく含んでいたことが地域だけの問題にせず、地域外に共感を広げました。
すいません、さっきこれですよね。
ここですね。
And one of the issue about this site was that it wasn't not only about the site itself, it also included a water line.That went through different towns.
そのことを、広く知ってもらうために取り組まれた粘り強い学習運動が事態を打開するポイントでした。
And the community movement, community learning movement against these, this issue was the major turning point for the towns.
加えて問題の矛盾が科学的な手続きによって暴かれたということも大事なポイントだと私は見ています。
And also the one of the important point is that the community people not only use the resistance movement, they've also used the scientific ways to find the mistakes and used it to go against the state plans.
2つ目の話題です。2つ目に用意をしたのは電気をめぐる話題です。
The second topic is about the electricity.
震災後、津波で被災した仙台平野に、より安全でクリーンな電気を自分たちで作ろうとする動きが現れました。日襟の市民共同発電所 NPO キラキラ発電は被災後の仙台平野で、再生困難な農地などを活用して自然エネルギーによる発電所を市民が共同出資して作り出す試みです。
And in Japan, after the tsunami in 2011, there was a movement by the citizens to come up with more clean energy. And one of the movement was thatThey came up with a civic movement called NPO Kirakira, Kirakira Power Plant. Kirakira means a twinkle in Japanese. And this power plant was entirely supported by the civic people, jointly supported. And they were using a unusable land in Sendai Plains to generate a reusable energy.
今この真ん中におられる方が水戸部さんというキラキラ発電の代表の方 でこの方はもともと医師です。で震災直後には大勢の方々の健康と命を実際守った方なんですが、退職金を拠出してそういう仲間を集めて発電所を実際に作ったんです。
The person you see on the middle is Mr.
水戸部、
はい、And he made up this study groupthat would study about such issues, and he also generated enough money to build this plant by people.
原発に反対の意見を持つだけでなく、オルタナティブを作るという取り組みを通して連帯を広げる、こういう動きが今仙台平野にあります。
And in Sendai, it's not only about the stopping the building of the plants, but it's also about coming up withother alternative sources of ways to make energy and study about such things and having such awareness raised by the public.
一方でその仙台平野に全く異なる発電所を建設する動きが現れ、地元に大きな波紋を投げかけています。東京の電力会社ではなくて関西や四国の、西日本の電力会社が関東圏に売電するための石炭火力発電所を建設するという動きです。震災の被災地は、地価が安い、ということに加え、福島や女川の原発関連で送電網が整備されているのが業者からすれば好都合ということです。
And also on the other hand, and there's also a movement in Sendai Plains to build a something entirely different, the power plant, which one of them is not by its local electrical company, but also by a company from the Kansai region, which is very far from Tohoku, as well as the Shikoku or the regions of West Japan, and they are trying to build a part, and they're trying to sell their energy in Kanto area, and they're trying to build a coal-fired electrical power plant in the area.However, because it's very cheap to build such plants in the area that was affected by the tsunami, so they try to build such, they're trying to build such plants in Fukushima or Onagawa, which is around Fukushima.
よそ者の企業が被災地に、時代遅れで環境リスクが高い石炭火力による発電所を作るという動きを住民が快く思うはずはありません。しかも日本の法律で環境アセスメントを義務付けた基準をわずかに下回る発電量が設定されており、こうしたやり方でアセスメントを逃れようとする企業の姿勢に大きな怒りが、今つながっているということです。
And now, if you think about it, coal-powered power plants are kind of not of the time. And people, the local residents, are not happy about having such kind of the power plants of the old times. And also, in Japanese, under the Japanese law, the Japanese law has a standard for having Japanese law has a standard where there has to be a certain level of electricity generated. If the electricity generated is too much or it goes over the rate that is set by the government, they can sell it. The companies can sell it. And this is not being welcomed by the people.
汚染を心配する住民に企業が説明会を初めて開いたのは今年の3月です。
The March of this year is the first time these companies have actually started having a conference for the community people to explain about what they're actually going to build.
企業の予想に反し、膨大な住民が詰めかけました。今見ていただいている写真は、その運動を起こしている団体のホームページの写真ですが、まさにその時の出来事です。
The picture you see is the picture from the first conference. And you see the community residents are actually against such plans, and they came to express their disapproval.
このホームページには住民有志が録画したその時の映像が YouTube で公開されています。その内容を見ると発電所の仕組みや環境リスクをめぐってかなり専門的な内容まで住民が事前に深く学び客観的に鋭く問題を指摘している。それに比べ企業の返答が貧弱で不誠実なことがはっきり見て取れます。
And actually, they actually uploaded the video of this conference on YouTubeAnd if you look at the video, you can see that the local residents are very keen and they have a lot of information about these power plants, even at the level that is usually not, even at the very professional level. And you can see that the residents have actually studied and they are looking at the issue, issue not from the personal point of view, but also from the scientific and,point of view.
飛ばしますね。ここで指摘しておきたいのは、関東圏のために電気を作り続けてきた福島第一原発事故と同じ構図が改めて作られつつあるということです。
What I would like to point out is that what happened at Fukushima is actually happening again in Kanto area as well.
しかし震災を経た今それを許さない民意がかつての東北社会には見られなかった強さと粘りで抵抗しているということです。
However, after the earthquake, people are not actually accepting such things, and we're seeing a lot of resistance from the civic and civil society against such plans in Japan.
時間が迫ってきましたね。急がないといけない。3つ目のエピソードに行きます。最後のエピソードは食をめぐってです。
And the last episode is about the food.
宮城県の西北部の山間の町、鳴子に日本の農業界の常識を覆す、そういう動きが始まり、今10年を迎えました。
It has been 10 years since we've seen a movement in Miyagi Prefecture. There is a town called 鳴子.Which is on the northwest side of Miyagi Prefecture, and here they're seeing a movement which actually goes against the usual reception of the Japanese agricultural environment.
かつてこの鳴子の米というのは非常にまずい米の代名詞だったんです。とても水が冷たいところで、冷たい水のところではいい米はできません。
Before times, the rice of this Narugo was considered very untasteable because the water of this town is very cold, and we usually say that if the water is too cold, we cannot make a good rice.
その鳴子で2006年に始まったのが今から説明するプロジェクトです。農家の皆さんだけでなくて、旅行業者など地域の異業種が集って協議を重ねた結果、計画ができました。でその中身は近年の米の2倍以上の価格をあえて設定し、その価格と品質に納得をした食べ手のみに注文販売するという仕組みです。
And in that Narugo town, in 2006, they began a project called the the rice production of Narugo. And this is not just the farmers, but also the local hotel people have, and as well as the other businesses have come together and work toward having a new plan, which was that to raise the price of the rice twice as higher than it as it is, and also sell the rice only to the people who order it beforehand.
日本では米の価格は政府が決めるものであって農家が決められないというのが従来の仕組みです。
Usually in Japan, the rice price is set by the government, and private companies or private farms cannot raise its price.
その結果、現在の米の値段では、時給に換算すると数十円にしかならないと。
So as a result,If you calculate the rice price into the hourly wage, it's only about less than 100 yen per hour.
私たちは来年もこの価格であれば米作りが継続できるという価格を自分たちで、設定した。それが前代のこれまでなかったことだったんです。
And what happened in Narugo is that they say that they have they set the price of the rice to the price where they can continue making the rice at this price. And this is the first time in Japan that it has happened.
このプロジェクトが動き出した契機は、この土地でも作れる、冷たい水でも作れる美味しい新しい米の品種を地域で開発をしたということでした。
The project began by, because, in the area, they succeeded in coming up with a new type of rice, whichcan also taste good, even though it has been produced using a cold water.
しかし時間の関係でそのことは述べません。ここで取り上げたいのは、この米の持ち味を最大に引き出すための学習、調査、研究が、地元のお母さんや職人たちなど地域総ぐるみで膨大に重ねられてきたということです。
Because we're running out of time, I'm only going to point out the main point of this project.The important thing is that when people succeeded coming up with the new type of rice, the result came from the years of community people working together, doing their experiments and succeeding in such experiments through community learning.
今3つの事例を紹介しましたけれども、これらに共通して一体どういう学習が展開されているのかということについて今から述べます。3つの特徴をお話したいと思います。
I've talked about the three examples from the community, and now I'm going to talk about the three features of the learning that created this success.
第一に、言いたいのは、これらに共通しているのは、地域では人々が意外と分断している。でそういう状況であるところを超えて、同じ課題を抱えている者同士であることを確認し合い、その解決をみんなで検討し合う、そういった関係を作り出すまでが実に丁寧に取り組まれているということです。
First of all, all of these examples actually show that although people think differentlyIn communities, people are actually very kind of, they're not put together, they're very divided.
そこで大事なのは問題状況の共有とその解決に向けての参加のいざないです。
However, at this, as a way to solve such issue, they came up with working together on the same issue. AndThe most important thing here is that to share the same issues and work together towards solving such issue.
上町の廃棄物処理問題をめぐっても、仙台港の発電所問題をめぐっても同様で、真っ当に生きている者がリスクにさらされることへのおかしさへの共感づくりと、その改善への参加へのいざないが丁寧に積み重ねられています。
As we saw on the Kamitown issues about the final repository, the first example, and also about the power plant issue of the Sendai, which was the second example, what we see is that The empathy is being built upon how. Could you go back? Go back.
Oh, sorry.
Being accumulated on the sense of unfairness and hostility towards the people who actually try, who are actually living honestly, but they're the ones who fall most vulnerable to such risk. But what can we do to participate, improve in such situation?
第2に、科学的共同的な地域の診断です。
Secondly, it's about looking at the community with the scientific and collaborative eyes.
時間の関係で、もうこれ以上取ることができないものですから、このスライドには私が聞き取った当事者の言葉が掲載されています。彼らがどんなことに取り組んできたのかということをスライドで確認をしていただければと思います。
And because we ran out of time, I would like everybody to look at the slides. This is the voices from the people that who were involved in the rice production project.
じゃあ飛ばしますね。最後です。3つ目ですけども、仲間を広げ、外ともつながる粘り強い学習運動が展開されている。つまり地域だけではなくて、他の地域とつながるということです。
And lastly, it's about the having more people involved and also connecting to other communities outside of their community through learning.
ナルコのプロジェクトでの言葉はいくつかここに書いてありますけれども、発足当時、プロジェクトの、意味をまとめた資料を作って、それを手元に携え、ぶれない、活動をしていこうということを確認し、地域の各地にさまざまな方々を、口説いて回ったという、そういう経験が膨大に積み重ねられています。
And as you see, this is also the voices from the people who were involved in the Naruko project. And you see that how these people went around the community and talking to other people to get them to work together.
そして一番大事なのは地域の中だけではなくて、外の方々に地域を学んでいただくということです。ナルコのプロジェクトでは、作り手と食べ手の新しい信頼関係を丁寧に作っていくということが一番大事なことだというように語られています。
And as we see on the Naruko project example, the most important thing was to creating a relationship between the producer, the food producer, and the consumers. So creating a relationship between not only the community itself, but the people from the outside of the community to get them understand what's happening in the community.Was the most important.
すなわち持続可能な地域を導こうとするならば、学習や取り組みが当該地域のみで完結するようなものではダメだということです。地方が消費者を納得させられるだけの教育力を持つことが要だということです。
So what is most important in leading a community for sustainability is that it's not only the learning or theNot only the community learning, but it's also the learning has to continue even outside the community. If the learning stays inside the community, it's not going to work.
以上、どれほどテクノロジーが発達したとしても、人間が果たさなければならない役割として残されるものの主要なものが、こうした地域を超えて連帯と正義と代案を導き出す地域の学習なのではないかというのが私の提案であり、そのための条件について韓国、ひいては世界の皆さんとともに検討することができれば幸いです。
So, how, even although in this time of the technological innovation, still we have these such as the community, these connecting with other communities.And the people is one of the most important things, even in this time of the technological innovation. And this is the only humans can do this. So I would like everybody to think about the conditions that could bring about this community involvement. Not only the people of here of Korea today, but also people of the world. And think about this.
時間を消化して申し訳ございませんでした。以上でございます。
Sorry for going over the time.